Hey everybody, welcome back to The Garage. If this is your first time visiting my channel, please go ahead, click on subscribe, and also click on the bell to receive all the updates and activities on my channel. Also click on the playlist to get up to date on the build of this XCR. Alright, so in the previous video, we went ahead and did the wet sanding, and actually, I ended up putting on the graphics yesterday as well. The weather turned out to be not so great, so we didn't go anywhere, so I used the time to put on the graphics. So, you know, as I was doing the conversion of the video, I noticed that the color correction on it made the sled kind of look orange or red or whatever. So, just wanted to do a quick walk around this. You know, we got the garage doors open, sunlight and everything else is on instead of the fluorescence, and kind of give you a better idea on how the sled looks and how the paint actually turned out. So, this is, I noticed yesterday when I was doing the conversion on it, it really didn't represent as far as how the hood came out. So, but this will give you a better idea. So the graphics, you know, there's a saying, you know, beggars can't be choosers, because right now Polaris doesn't offer any graphics for their older sleds. So you gotta get what you can get. So again, these are reproduction graphics, and as far as the overall quality, I'm gonna give it a 8 out of 10. You know, as far as material, it seems to be fine. All the colors and everything else seems to be fine. You know, we got the decals on the trailing arms. The biggest issue I had is on the big graphic, which goes around the white panel, is essentially that graphic has to be right from the get-go, because essentially it's the border around the white panel. So it needs to be the correct length and the correct width. And what I ran into on both sides is that graphic is probably about 5% too narrow and about 5% too short. And so, because what it is, you know, if you remember that white pan, that white section essentially steps down, and then, you know, the blue border of the graphic needs to follow it and needs to cover it up. And because it was too narrow, I really had to fight with it and everything else to get it to line up. And the graphic is actually too short, because if you look, it doesn't make it all the way back to the hood. Is actually short by about 3/8 of an inch on both sides. Okay, so it was an issue with the installation. It's the same result on both sides. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm actually going to reach out to the seller on eBay and say, hey, this is what the issue is. I'm going to send them pictures, and my hope is essentially he can just remanufacture, you know, 10 inches of the graphic on the front, and essentially I'll strip that off and reapply it, so it actually makes the all the way up on the nose cone. And another thing that was in the kit was, you know, there's supposed to be a graphic that goes over the script for Polaris. It's actually about 10% too short and on the height, so it actually doesn't line up. So I gotta contact him about that as well, because right now the graphic that's supposed to essentially wrap around joining these two is not correct. So we gotta essentially get that corrected as well. So hopefully the seller on eBay will come through. So, all right, so the next steps on this sled is, what we have to do is we gotta pull the back bumper off and the front bumper off. I'm gonna repaint them. And then once they're painted, we'll apply the decals in the channel of the bumpers. And also, we're gonna repaint the belly pan strip. And the reason I saved that for last is, you know, because we've been working on the sled for 2 or 3 months in manhandling and everything else, and I didn't want to paint the bumpers and, you know, end up risking chipping them and scuffing them and everything else. So we saved those last on purpose. So after that, there's a couple other things we gotta do. Gotta paint the exhaust, and gotta change the primary clutch on this. I noticed that the primary clutch actually has a pretty good score on the clutch sheave, so that's no good. We're gonna actually pull the clutch out of the end of the trail. It's actually the same clutch, but the spring is different, so we'll just basically replace the spring. We'll document that. Another thing we have to do is we got to pull the carbs off this thing again, because what's going on with it now is the sled will not run off of idle. Essentially, when it runs, it's loading up and everything else, and basically it's choking itself off. Pretty sure I know what happened was when we were getting it off the trailer and everything else and whatever, and rolling it left and right to put the exhaust, put the suspension in, one of the needles and seats is hung up, and it's just allowing excess gas to run into the engine and choke itself off. Because what will happen is it'll get so bad there's actually gas coming out of the carb. So it's either the needle and seats are bad in it, or the fuel pump is bad in it. So it's one of those two things. The gas can only come from two places. So, but luckily, my friend Darren Max actually sent me some rebuild kits. So we're gonna use those to rebuild the carbs on that thing. So thank you very much. All right, so again, that's it. Hope you like this. If there's any questions, comments, concerns, go ahead and leave them in the comments box. I'll get back to you as soon as I can, and stay tuned for the next update. Thanks.